When you look at the ocean, it really looks all the same as far as the eye can see in many ways. One of the jokes my children have is I took them, one of their first boat trips was off the coast of Florida, and I said, well, maybe we'll hit the Gulf Stream. And about every 10 minutes they kept saying, are we in the Gulf Stream yet? And you can't ever tell when you're in the Gulf Stream unless you're making an enormous number of measurements because you don't see it. There's so much happening that the eye cannot see. I'm a paleoceanographer who looks at biological fossils back through time to understand how the ocean has changed over the last 500 to 1,000 years. The first question we ask is, what information do we want to know about the Earth? And where can we go on the planet to best answer those questions? Once you've sort of identified that location, we go out, we look for the largest coral that we can find. Corals grow in these large formations and they're building skeleton as they grow. And as they secrete their skeletons, they will take in chemicals from the seawater based on the conditions they're growing in. So as the temperature changes, they're going to have a different chemical composition. As the salinity changes, they're going to have a different chemical composition. As surface currents change, they're going to reflect those changes in their skeleton as well. The corals that we're interested in grow into really, really large boulders that can live for, you know, 500 or 600 years. And then we go ahead and we'll drill a core out from the center of that colony. It doesn't kill the colony continues to thrive for decades afterwards. But it gives us a little bit of a piece from the inside of that colony that extends back through time. Once you have the samples in the lab, we look at certain trace elements like strontium and barium that can tell us about what's been happening in that coral. And so we can reconstruct those environmental conditions over the past several hundred years. And looking back in time and understanding how this system works is very critical to understanding how climate will change in the future. Our technologies change dramatically in a 10 to 15 year time period. And so the type of analysis that we're able to do on these samples 15 years from now is very different than the analysis we're able to do now. And being at a place that is collecting and preserving such an enormous amount of the Earth's history through sample collection, and to be working on not just trying to collect new data all the time, but trying to go back and look at what else can we learn that we didn't know we could learn, you know, 20 years ago. That's what really excited me about coming to the American Museum of Natural History.